The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hi my dear snappy children, welcome back. How are you all? Hope everybody is happy and healthy at home. Now, summer season started, so drink plenty of water, take fresh vegetables and fruits and be healthy. Okay? Because health is wealth. God's creations are wonderful, isn't it, children? God created everyone to enjoy the beauties of life. But God created certain people as differently abled because they are so special to God. Do you know who they are? Yes. People with disabilities like deaf, dumb, blind, lame, etc. Have you ever thought of the challenges they have faced in their life? Even though they have these disabilities, God has given certain talents to them. Just imagine, children, if we were in their position, what could be the condition? So today, let's learn a lesson, the School for Sympathy, where the students show how to take care of others. Yes, the School for Sympathy is a story written by E.V. Lucas. The story tells about Miss Beam's school and the others' visit to the school. He explains the things that when he entered the campus and also describes the system that has followed in Beam's school. So let's move to the School for Sympathy. Edward Vera Lucas was a famous English humorist, essayist, playwright, biographer, publisher, poet, novelist, short story writer, and editor. Born in London, Lucas began to work as an apprentice to a bookseller at the age of 16. He was a prolific writer, most celebrated for his short essays, but he also produced verses, novels, and plays. Schools are centers of learning where we acquire knowledge and share our experiences. Right, children? So, let's move to the School for Sympathy. I had heard a lot about Miss Beam's school, but I did not get the chance to visit it till last week. When I arrived at the school, I saw a girl of about 12 with her eyes covered with a bandage being led carefully between the flower beds by a little boy of 8. She stopped and asked who it was that had come in, and he seemed to be describing me to her. Then they passed on. I had heard a lot about Miss Beam's school. Who is I here in this lesson? Yes, our author, E.V. Lucas. So he had heard a lot about Miss Beam's school, but he did not get the chance to visit the school. And he arrived at the school. Now, when I arrived at the school, I saw a girl of about 12 with her eyes covered with a bandage being led carefully between the flower beds by a little boy of 8. So when he entered the school, he saw a girl whose eyes were bandaged and she was led by a small boy of 8. She stopped and asked who it was that had come. So she asked the little boy who had come to our school, and the little boy explained to her and they moved on. Miss Beam was all that I had expected. Middle-aged, authoritative, kind and understanding. Her hair was beginning to turn grey and her round figure was likely to be comforting to a homesick child. So Miss Beam, the owner of the school, Miss Beam was all that I had expected. Who has expected? Yes, our author. He had expected. She was a middle-aged, authoritative. Authoritative means reliable, trustworthy, kind, and understanding. Her hair was beginning to turn gray. It shows she was a middle-aged woman, and her round figure was likely to comforting to a homesick child. So it was a residential school. So children used to, the boys and girls used to stay there and study. So she was like a mother to them. She was supporting everyone. We chatted for a while, and when I asked her some questions about her teaching methods, which I had heard were simple, she said, "We teach only those things that are simple and useful to pupils. Spelling, adding, subtracting, multiplying, writing, etc. The rest is done by reading to them and giving them interesting tasks. There are practically no other lessons." I have heard so much, I said, about the originality of your system. Miss Bean smiled. "Ah, yes," she said, "I am coming to that." So the conversation started between Miss Beam and our author, Evie Lucas. We chatted for a while. We means here? Yes. The author and Miss Beam. When I asked her some questions about her teaching methods, she replied that their teaching methods were very simple. "We teach only those things that are simple and useful to pupils." Pupils means students. So the teachings were spellings, adding, subtracting, multiplying, writing, etc. The rest is done by reading to them and giving them interesting tasks. So they are giving different tasks to improve their knowledge. There are practically no other lessons. I have heard so much. Who had heard so much? Yes, our author. I said, about the originality of your system. So our author already have heard so much about the education system of Miss Beam's school. Miss Beam smiled and said, "I am coming to that." So she was going to explain more about the teaching methods. "The real aim of this school is not to teach thought, but thoughtfulness, humanity, kindness, and citizenship. That is the ideal I have always had, and happily there are parents good enough to trust me to try and put into practice. Look out of the window a minute, will you?" So the real aim of this school, which school? Yes, Miss Bean school, was not to teach thought, but thoughtfulness. Thoughtfulness means thoughtful about others. Chindasheshi. Humanity. What do you mean humanity? Manishatvam. Kindness, daya, and citizenship. Citizenship means pauratva. So the real aim of the school was to teach humanity, citizenship, kindness, and thoughtfulness. "And I have always had happily there are parents good enough to trust me." So parents trusted her and the school, send their children happily to the school. "Look out of the window a minute, will you?" So Miss Beam asked to Lucas to look out the window for a minute. I went to a window which looked out on a large garden and playground at the back. "What do you see?" Miss Beam asked. "I see some very beautiful grounds," I said, "and lot of jolly children. But what surprises me and pains me too is that they are not at all healthy and active. As I came in, I saw one poor little thing being led about because of some trouble with her eyes. And now I can see two more in the same condition, while there is a girl with a crutch just under the window watching others at play. She seems to be a hopeless cripple." Miss Beam laughed. Why did Miss Beam laugh? Let's see. When Miss Beam asked our author to look out of the window, he saw beautiful grounds and lot of jolly children. He surprised, at the same time, he felt bad. Actually, he said that the children were not at all healthy and active. "As I came in, I saw one poor little thing being led about because of some trouble with her eyes." So when our author entered the campus, entered the school, he saw a girl whose eyes were bandaged, isn't it? And now I can see two more in the same condition, while there is a girl with a crutch just under the window watching others at play. So by hearing these things, Miss Beam laughed. Oh no, she said. Who said? Miss Beam. She is not lame really. There is only her lame day. Nor are those others blind. It is only their blind day. So actually, the girl was not blind and the second girl was not lame. I must have looked very much astonished, for she laughed again. There you have an essential part of our system in a nutshell. Nutshell means a brief. Chirukatil. In order to get these young minds to appreciate and understand misfortune means those who are in difficulties, we make them share in misfortune too. So actually Miss Beam wanted to teach the children to experience the difficulties of disabled children. In the course of the term, every child has one blind day, one lame day, one deaf day and one dumb day. So in their course of education, the child must go through these days. During the blind day, their eyes are bandaged and it is a point of honor not to peep. The bandage is put on overnight, they wake up blind. This means they need assistance in everything. And the other children are told to help them and let them about. It is educative to both of them, the blind and the helpers. So during the blind day, the child's eyes were bandaged the night itself. So she woke up blind. So obviously she needs a helper, isn't it, for everything. Everyone is very kind, Miss Beam continued. And it is really something of a joke, although, of course, before the day is over, the reality of disability becomes clear even to the least thoughtful. So when they overcome these days, the children would really understand the difficulties of the disabled people. The blind day is, of course, really the worst. But some of the children tell me that the dumb day is most frightening. Though, of course, the child must use willpower only because the mouth is not bandaged. So blind day is, blind means kannu kanathavar. Blind day is very worst, but some children used to tell to Miss Beam that dumb day is most frightening. What do you mean by dumb? Samsarikan pattathavar. So when the blind day, their eyes were bandaged, but in the dumb day, they won't bandage their mouth, so they have to use the power to not to talk, to remain silent. But come down into your garden and see for yourself how the children like it. Miss Beam led me to one of the bandaged girls, a little merry thing. Here is a gentleman come to talk to you, said Miss Beam and left us. So Miss Beam introduced Lucas to a girl and she left. Don't you ever peep? I asked by the way of an opening. So when he met the girl whose eyes were bandaged, he asked the question, don't you ever peep? Oh no, she exclaimed, that would be cheating. So she replied, I won't do that, that would be cheating. But I had no idea it was so awful to be blind. You can't see a thing. One feels one is going to hit by something every moment. Sitting down is such a relief. So the girl was explaining about the blind day, the difficulties of a blind person to Lucas. So since you can't see anything, you feel you are going to hit someone or something every moment. Are your guides kind to you? I ask. Pretty good. Not as careful as I shall be when it's my turn. Those that have been blind already the best. It is terrible not to see. I wish you would try. Shall I lead you anywhere? I ask. So the conversation between the girl and Lucas continued and he asked, shall I lead you anywhere? Oh yes, she said. Let's go for a little walk. Only you must tell me about things. I shall be so gladful when today's over. These are the words of girl. The other bad days can't be half as bad as this. Having a leg tied up and hopping about on a crutch is almost a fun, I guess. Having an arm tied up is a little more troublesome because you have to get your food cut up for you and so on. but it doesn't really matter. So the girl was describing about the lame day and some other days to Lucas. And so for being a deaf for a day, I should not mind that, at least not much. But being blind is so frightening. My head aches all the time, just from avoiding things that probably aren't there. Where are we now? In the playground, I said. So the girl explained the difficulties of each day, and she explained that being blind was the most difficult thing. And she asked, where are we now? In the playground, I said, going towards the house. Miss Beam is walking up and down the terrace with a tall girl. He explained to the girl. What has the girl got on? My companion asked me. Who is my companion here? Yes, the girl whose eyes were bandaged. A blue skirt and a pink blouse. I think it's Millie, she said. What color is her hair? Very light, I said. Yes, that's Millie. She is the head girl. She is very decent. So the girl found out that was a leader of the school, that is Millie, and she was a very good girl, decent girl. Then he explained, Lucas explained, there's an old man tying a process. Yes, that's Peter. Again, the girl found out he's a gardener. He's hundreds of years old. And here comes a dark girl in red on crutches. Yes, she said, that's Beryl. And so we walked on, and in guiding the little girl, I discovered that I was many times more thoughtful already than usual. I also realized that having to describe the surroundings to another makes them more interesting. So now only he realized the difficulties of disabled people. When Miss Beam came to release me, I was sorry. So he was very sad to leave the place. I walked back to the town murmuring the lines. Can I see another's woe? Woe means sorrow. And not share their sorrows too. Oh no, never can it be, never, never can it be. So, after visiting the school, he became more thoughtful about the difficulties of others. And he realized how the disabled people facing the difficulties in their life. So, Miss Beam has a unique system of teaching. Teaching to be thoughtful about others. She imparted this kind of education by making every child experience the difficulties of disabled people by living like the disabled for a day. So, the real aim of the school was to make the children sensitive and good citizens, kind and responsible. So, a normal child should know all the difficulties faced by the disabled children and how to respect them. My dear children, I hope you understood the story, the moral of the lesson, sharing and caring. Got it? Yes. So, today's homework is write a character sketch of Miss Beam and write about the education system of the school. Got it? Yes. So that's all for today. We will be in the next class. And that's bye from your in the teacher. Thank you.